So what's up, JosefVStalin, and welcome to my fifth part of Let's Play Empire Total War. And in this part, I unfortunately do not have another battle for you. The next battle will be coming in the next part, and it's going to be a battle with me versus some of these Transylvanian rebels. For this part, I've got a significant backlog of questions that I'm going to get to. A quick status update. I've beaten the Persians back. And I've taken Afghanistan and their other province, and they also took an Indian province of Punjab. I've also taken that from them. That now belongs to me. And I'm preparing for my final assault to take them out of Azerbaijan. But even better, I've beaten back the Austrians into a stalemate in Europe. I took back Sarajevo, and I also took Transylvania from them. And it was a pretty bloody war. I practically wore them down like one unit at a time, because they consistently send one unit into my territory and I'd kill it, and they send another and another and another until they had nothing left, and I was able to take Transylvania. And once I did that, I requested for some peace. They signed a peace treaty with me, and Russia signed a peace treaty with me. Eastern Front is secure, and I'm winning on the Western Front, and I'm all gearing up for the final takeover of these last four provinces here, and then I can start taking on the Austrians again. But let's get into these questions I have. Exen, he asked me talking about a lack of content in Empire Total War. He says it would have been cool. Have things like more of Asia, like China, Japan, Korea, and I have to agree that that would be awesome, and I really hope to do something like that in an expansion, especially Japan, because Japan was kind of, you know, it was kind of reaching a turning point where it was abandoning the Shogun and abandoning the feudal system, and I think it would be really cool to play as Japan during that pivotal change in its diplomatic and economic structure. I think that would be awesome, and I really hope they put that in a expansion. But what I'm going to disagree with Exen here is the lack of content, because the amount of content in this game is absurd. I mean, there's just huge tracts of land to cover already, more than in any other Empire Total War game, and far more in any other strategy game besides like Hearts of Iron or certain civilization mods, to my knowledge. So Empire Total War does definitely not have a lack of content. Moving on, Captain RTS wants to know, a good place to start is Great Britain. A good place to start is Great Britain is if you take Georgia, the Cherokee Territory, and Quebec, you gain the entire eastern seaboard and all the seven colonies. But as you can see right now, Britain's in kind of a rough shape, as the Americans have already begun their rebellion and are moving down the 13 colonies. So Britain's in a rough way, but once you take those three territories, you gain the 13 colonies and these seven territories here. And from there, it's good to wipe out the Cherokees and take out the French from America and monopolize North America. And then if you can gain a foothold in India, because there's a lot of riches to be found in India, so get there fast and start taking a few select territories there, and you'll be better off for it in the future. And of course, if anyone else wants to give them a couple tips, they're more than welcome to chime in the comments. Moving right on, Crown Prince of Sweden says his game crashes when he puts troops onto ships and then like clicks on the ships because he's trying to take over North America. I've had that problem before. What seems to solve that problem is shutting down programs in the background. So make sure nothing's running but Empire Total War. Oddly enough, it seems to happen when there's a lot of ocean on screen. Like, I remember I had a ship in Burma near the Bahamas, and when I click on it, the game would crash. But if I had a ship more towards the coastline, it wouldn't crash. And then sometimes I'd just play a couple turns in ahead and the game would stop crashing when I would click on those ships. So I besides that, I don't know what else to say. It's a fairly common bug, and lots of people have dealt with it. And if that doesn't help, I'm sure if you search, there'd be plenty of resources to help you. Moving on, BruteU asks, he says, I bought the Mega Pack for Rome Total War and I can't play online. And I really can't help you because I never played Rome Total War online, so I wouldn't know where to start at all with that. But there's two things in the comments that I like to address. Arda 5841 asked when I did my battle against Georgia if I would have restarted the game. If I would have showed it even if I lost that battle. What I would have done is I would have restarted and keep playing that battle over and over and over until I found a strategy that worked and until I could have comfortably won that battle. Because, one, I think that's how you learn what works and what doesn't, is you keep doing and you keep trying new things until you find a strategy that works. Two, I'm a huge perfectionist. Whenever I play, whenever I do anything in my life, I always want to do it to perfection, and of course, this spills over into Empire Total War, and if I do something that I think could have been done better, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna do it that way and I'm gonna keep doing it until I am satisfied with it. So that's kind of how I play this game, and that's kind of how I am as a person. That comes, you know, into my schoolwork, into my, you know, my friendships, my love life, everything. If I'm just a huge perfectionist, a fan of things, ask me what technology and what economics, you know, areas I'm pushing. In terms of economics, I'm pushing every single area. I'm pushing my farms, I'm pushing my ports, my metalworks, my textiles, everything that I can possibly upgrade, I upgrade. But in terms of technologies, usually I focus on military technologies, but with the Ottoman Empire, it's a lot harder to recruit standing line infantry. So I focused a lot more to farming, and I'm focusing on more farming and economic techs in order to bring up those parts of my economy so I can eventually be able to recruit standing military troops, standing line infantry in more cities with the money I'm going to be producing from these new industrial advances, so to speak. And I've also been dabbling in a little bit of philosophy, but this time most the economics versus my traditional line infantry. But there's something I want to ask you guys before I wrap this up. But first off, I want to say I'm sorry about not having a lot of battles, because most of the battles I'm fighting right now are just minor, like 3 versus 4 units of troops. And there's not these like really awesome, really like 1,000 man army on 1,000 man army, so there haven't been a lot of exciting battles to show. But I want to ask you guys something, because I found this awesome new show. It's called The Deadliest Warrior. It's like the most nerdy show in existence, but what it is, it's a bunch of like scientists who come together and they examine tactics and weaponry of two different types of warriors, and then they simulate that to see who would win in a fight if they would ever come together. Like I watched, they did a knight versus a pirate. They did the Sicilian mafia versus the Japanese yakuza, and next week they're doing the Green Beret versus the Spetsnaz. And I just want to hear what you guys think would win out of those three. So again, it's knight versus pirate, yakuza versus Sicilian mafia, and Spetsnaz versus American Green Berets. And I'm hoping to start like a little bit of flame war just to see what you guys think. And also, if you get the chance, check this show out. It's awesome. It's called Deadliest Warrior. I believe it's on Spike TV, but I just had to plug that because I think that show was awesome. So anyway, let me know what you guys think, This is going to be Joseph VStalin signing off for now, and I'll hopefully have some more exciting battles for you next time.